Kelly. Where are you? Ah, you're there. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome to the Netherlands, to Amsterdam, home to one of the world's biggest internet exchanges. I'm delighted to be speaking to the people who are building the infrastructure that will enable Europeans to reap the full benefits of the digital age. The Netherlands aims to be a leader in this field, and we have a reputation to uphold. We were the first country in Europe to gain access to the internet in 1988, when it was still the preserve of the military and the academic community. But in 1993, it was opened up to everyone around the world. Only it was often too slow that www could easily have stood for worldwide waiting. Oh. The aim is to ensure that, wherever you are in the Netherlands, you will have the perfect connectivity. That is the connectivity you need to work in the cloud, to stream TV programs in 3D, or to hold a video call with several people at once. We must seize the opportunities offered by digital with both hands. The digital transformation is crucial for a strong Dutch economy. It's also leading to groundbreaking solutions to issues facing society. Examples include e-health, video conferencing to reduce the need for physical mobility, and the use of drones for precision farming. Another key component of my policy is preventing a digital divide. Mr. Kelly already spoke about it. Everyone must be given the chance to benefit from high-speed internet, whether they be young or old and live in a town or the country, especially in the latter case. Rural flight is resulting in population imbalances across Europe. Good digital connectivity will help ensure rural areas stay attractive for families and economic activity. We want to keep track of how the target of 100 megabits per second is progressing for everyone in the Netherlands. That's why we have developed a so-called broadband map. The map shows the speed of the fixed internet connection at various levels, from country to address level. Recently, in the east of the country, I officially launched the Netherlands' 3 millionth fiber connection at a care farm. This made their internet 100 times faster, allowing them to digitalize their entire operation and watch Netflix on the sofa. Of course, I realize that in the Netherlands, we're in a privileged position. If you are from a bigger country like France or Poland, what we, the Dutch, think as rural or remote area might bring a smile to your face. But our aim in Europe is to ensure that remote addresses in your countries get high-speed connection too. That's why I think we need to modify EU rules on state aid when it comes to rolling out fiber networks. Even in the Netherlands, there can be places where fiber networks are not commercially viable. This is where the government should be able to lend a hand. Another aspect the government should look at is regulation. If you want to lay fiber cables, then in the Netherlands and many other countries, you have to contend with widely varying municipal and provincial regulations. For example, how deep can you dig? Where can you place an antenna or a switching station? What is the permit procedure and what does it cost? What are the rules on restoring the road surface once the work is complete? I'm well aware that you have to go to great lengths to find out these things in each and every locality where you operate. So in the Netherlands, I'm promoting the share of best practices so that local authorities can adopt methods that have proved a success elsewhere, and there is greater uniformity. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Kelly, as I said, I'm pleased to have this opportunity to speak to you, because business and government need each other in order to offer people in our countries the best possible digital connectivity. I've touched on a couple of areas where I feel the government can modify its approach. It is mainly about helping to connect remote homes and promoting efficient regulation. After all, it is the duty of government working within the relevant political and administrative criteria not to make your task as infrastructure companies more difficult than it already is. So, let's work together. Let's create a healthy market for businesses, and a digital society that works for us all. Thank you very much for your attention.